If you thought the iPhone 11 Pro's camera setup was bad, wait till you see the Galaxy S11. You will not be pleased.
Oh my God. No, God! No, God, please, no! 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 No!
I'm gonna tell you why I don't like the camera position at the end of the video, so be sure to stick around to find out. I am Kenno and this is Anchor Tech. Be sure to subscribe and hit the bell icon so you don't miss any future videos. This is our very first look of the Galaxy S11, courtesy of Onleaks, and considering his reliability and track record, we can agree that this is 90% the Galaxy S11. And that scares the shit out of me, because this is horrible. The camera position, the camera housing, all of it, it just looks bad. Okay, let's talk about the leak. First off, the biggest change is on the back. We have a new camera module. It's rectangular with rounded edges, and it houses 5 cameras and a flash. Of these 5 cameras, we know there's gonna be a 108 megapixel sensor, which has the biggest sensor size on any smartphone ever. That kind of explains the hideous camera module, alongside a 48 megapixel 5x periscope zoom lens, which also occupies some significant amount of space. There's also gonna be an ultra wide angle sensor and 1x of flight lens for depth. And I think the 5th sensor might just be a spectrometer. There were rumors that the Galaxy S11 was gonna have a spectrometer. Now, you might be asking, what's a spectrometer? It's a technology that can help you determine your body fat percentage and the moisture content of your skin. It can also tell you the sugar content in fruits, and it can also tell you the authenticity of a product, like drugs, and show you the amount of nutrition in food, so you know the amount of nutrition that's going into your body. And it does this by absorbing light reflected from an object, breaks it down into a spectrum, and analyzes it to determine its chemical content. Now, it's not certain that that's going to be a spectrometer, but I can't think of any other sensor that Samsung is going to use as a 5th. Now, we know Samsung's focus for the Galaxy S11 is the camera, and that means they're more focused on function over design, and that's not necessarily a bad thing. Really, people will be more interested in what it can do than what it looks like. The leak also shows that there's gonna be a camera bump, so it's not gonna be completely flushed in, and that is because of the larger sensor and the periscope zoom lens. Moving on the right side, we have the power and volume buttons. So, no more Bixby button, and also, no headphone jack. It's dead. And on the front, it's basically identical to the Note 10, with the punch hole being at the center instead of the side. And the bezels are gonna be smaller than the ones on the Note 10. Also, the corners are rounded and not squared off like the Note 10's, which is to be expected from an S series device. The display is gonna come in at 6.7 inches, which is the regular Galaxy S11. The S11 Plus is gonna be 6.9 inches, and it's gonna use the taller 20:9 aspect ratio. The edges are also gonna be less curved than the ones on the Galaxy S10, which is surprising because they made these waterfall displays for other companies, but they're not using it. In fact, they're doing the exact opposite by reducing the curves and the edges of their phones. But bear in mind, all S11 series are gonna have curved edges. There isn't gonna be a flat one like the Galaxy S10e. Now, why don't I like this camera placement on the Galaxy S11? It's quite simple actually. It's just too common. When you take a look at previous Galaxy devices, you just know it's a Samsung flagship, just by looking at the camera placement. And that was true up until the Galaxy S10. With the Note 10, they used an overcommon design. Every other company used it, and Samsung themselves used it on their mid-range devices. Now, that didn't look bad, so it was excusable. But the same cannot be said for this design. It's becoming overused, and it's the exact same design they used on the Galaxy AM30s, and the upcoming Galaxy A51 and A71 are gonna incorporate this design. Now, that just kinda shows they're not even trying to maintain the unique look that Samsung flagship has had for years, and that is what pisses me off with this design. But, just like every other render, it's gonna look hideous now and look way better when it's launched, and I'm gonna end up falling in love with it. So, let me know what you think about this design in the comment section below, and be sure to drop a like if you enjoyed the video. The S11 leaks are gonna keep coming, so if you wanna stay updated, be sure to subscribe and hit the bell icon so you don't miss any future videos. Thanks for watching, guys. See you in the next one.